Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to come and be trained, fellowship in your presence, O Lord. We thank you, Father, that you speak to us this wonderful evening. Thank you for the anointing. Thank you for the power, revelation, message of the hour. We thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father, for the wonderful weather. We receive the anointing in this weather. Thank you, Father, that you speak to us in our spirit, into our mind. We thank you for those that are live streaming around Fiji and around the globe. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Make sure you bless someone before you take your seat this evening. Hallelujah. Welcome you all in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So wonderful to be back here in that schooner nearly 1 month. Hallelujah. Or 2 months. Because we were going around during the rallies And now we are back in Bratiskuna in 2017. So we take this time to welcome you all in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We also take this time to welcome the team Fiji that went down to the state of California. Hallelujah. In the city of Santa Rosa. And we praise God for one time we were here discussing and encouraging people that it can be done. And we did it. Amen. And we thank the Lord for that. On the last night of our being there, and we went through another training that is on, I think it was on Wednesday, your Thursday. We went through teaching. And we calculate all the years of work with our senior pastors. Hallelujah. It came to about nearly 600 years experience. When we plus the years of work from different organizations, different departments, some government, some private sectors or company, it comes to about 500 something, nearly 600 years of experience. And Randini was sharing with us when we plus all those. Remember, those are the senior pastors that they went, not including the senior pastor that they were here. It goes to show that you are sitting among people that they have talented, gifted, experienced. You are sitting there. Every time you come to that school, Memorial School, for Monday training, remember, you are rubbing shoulders with people sitting next to you with tons of experience. And we don't know them. Hallelujah. Some are civil servants. Some are from private sectors. Some, they are full-time. They know how to live a life being a full-time, depending on God. And some, they have a good position in their work. So you are sitting there among people that they have experience. So even before we go through lessons, rubbing shoulders with eagle make you an eagle. Amen. Amen. So that means you must acknowledge and appreciate the people around you as leaders. Hallelujah. Because when we went through the numbers of years of experience, it came to about 5-8 something. And that's 500 years. Hallelujah. So that means there are some people qualified, some people, they are very experienced. So, as leaders, remember, look around you. You learn from people around you. And appreciate people around you, because sometimes you can learn being just with them and listen to them. And the environment around you will make you a good leader. This, for example, we have a Fiji team, either 7 or 15. They play rugby down there against a team. They play full, maybe full 7-a-side team. 7 minutes, turn around, 7 minutes again. Hallelujah. The same team, you take that to Albert Park. You will see the performance will be slightly different. From Albert Park, you take them to the National Stadium. Same team. And then the same team, you take them to Eden Park in Auckland. Thousands of people will be there. Same team from Ratchakuna. Same team from Albert Park. The same team that take them to National Stadium. Now, take them to Eden Park in Auckland. Or Sydney Cricket Ground in Sydney. You'll see the environment demand their performance to rise. You're coming here every Monday demand you to perform. Hallelujah. So the environment that you were exposed to will demand you to perform. They demand you. That's why we are taking away outside Fiji the boot camp. The first boot camp was in Nandabe. And then we moved to Sydney in Australia, Meru Christian Center. Now we just came back from Santa Rosa in the California of, in the state of California. Now we already confirmed to take it to England in this year. Amen. So there is a demand on leaders now to perform to what we call international level, international thinking. You are no longer a church that you are just down Kinoya and Nandera. No. We are on Facebook now. We are on television. So the leadership, the knowledge, the performance standing up here. We are not only talking to New Methodists that you are sitting here. The whole world have the access to our page, whether it's New Methodists or Jesus or Henry Sandy. And people are talking about it and they pass on from person to person. So even the environment demands our performance. Amen. So turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, it's time to perform. You're no longer small church, maybe in Lami somewhere, in maybe Kinikini, small church in maybe Kalikano, Gawia, a small church in Waila. No, you're no longer. The environment is demanding you to perform. Amen? Amen. So we really need to raise our level of leadership. We need to raise our level of maturity. We really need that. That's why we'll continue to train you. Whether you go to a school of management, or maybe you don't hold any management post, it doesn't really matter anymore now. You are demanded, you are expected to rise. That's why we're doing a lot of training now. And our training, Randini was sharing with the Tautangas when we were there, that there will be shortly, just a few days from now, or maybe weeks from now, that we will have a local senior pastor's boot camp, so we can come and do exercises. And maybe not only senior pastors, we will select few pastors from zone, those normally act. So we will increase our training, because the environment is demanding us to rise. And leaders, this is what we normally look for. We look for environment. When the environment changes, you have to tell your group to change. We rise with the environment. We can't change the environment, or the environment is changing. Sometimes we cannot control the changing environment. So whether we control or do not control, when the environment changes, as leader, you change. Amen. The environment demanded you to change. So that's why leaders, we need training after training after training after training, so we can rise to another level. Amen? Amen. 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 Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you need to rise. Hallelujah. You need to rise. Whether we like it or not, we need to rise. Hallelujah. Don't tell us that you've never been to school, that you can't rise. No. The Holy Spirit, our teacher, our counselor, will make you rise. When you say yes, when you're willing to rise, the Holy Spirit will make you rise. They don't care whether you're holding a degree or maybe a diploma. It's immaterial now. You are in a field that you demanded to rise. Amen. Hallelujah. So high five to your neighbor. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, you need to rise. 10 mistakes. Today I will share this one or two of this lesson. You can take it as 10 mistakes leaders make, or 10 mistakes Christians make. As a leader sitting here, you can change to Christian when you are speaking to the congregation. Hallelujah. But as I'm speaking to leaders, we will change the Christians to leaders. You see it as leaders. Okay, read as leaders. 2, 3. 10 mistakes leaders make. These are the mistakes that you and me, we normally make. So when you see these 10 things, make sure that you already learn how to divert, detour, or how you can overcome. Amen? Are you ready?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord for those that are listening and those are watching through Facebook or just watching through Meru Christian, Meru live streaming. We take this time just to welcome them in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us give a mighty hand clap around Fiji and around the globe. Hallelujah. 10 mistakes. There are 10 mistakes. Let us read from number 1 to number 10. Rua tolu. Slow about the ministry. That's one mistake. We are very slow about the ministry. Number 2, not serious about the sacrifice. The sacrifice is we are not serious that Jesus died on the cross, that somebody gave his life. We are not serious. We take it lightly. Number 3, 2, 3, not serious about humility. We don't take humility or humbleness seriously. Because what I'm saying yesterday, there's a phrase that comes up from my mouth yesterday. Walk on your knees and speak with your tears. That's humility. Hallelujah. We are not serious about humility. That our way up is going down. If you want to go up, you go down. That's humility. Humbleness. Number 4. Receiving honor from men. Number 5. Ignoring Jesus' word. Number 6. Disconnect from God. Number 7. Bearing few fruits. Number 8. Wrong priorities. Number 9. Becoming a Pharisee. Number 10. Having or focusing on earthly treasures. These are 10 mistakes that normally we do as a church member or as a leader. Hallelujah. And I believe one of these, I share it in Santa Rosa with a senior pastor attending the boot camp there. Hallelujah. I share with them the number 1, slow about the ministry. Can we go through that one again? Yes. Hallelujah. And maybe if time permits, we can go through number 1, number 2, or maybe number 3. So we'll start with number 1, slow about the ministry. Read with me, 2, 3. The ministry is a call of God, but many Christians are slow in obeying the call of God for the advancement of the ministry. God has a time and He knows what is happening and what will happen. So God knows what is happening now and God knows what will come later. That's why the ministry is called by God, to face the changing environment that will become. See? So when New Methodist is called back in 2002, I believe because it was a changing environment. It was a changing with time. Hallelujah. So when we started, when we start with preaching so hard and preaching with like uncompromised word of God, it's something new. God knew that the church start to compromise with the gospel. Hallelujah. Only God knows what is coming and what is happening. Because nothing happened according God allowed it to happen. So being a Christian, so being a leader, remember, you must respond to the call of God in your life. You must be ready to respond. When God called, He called because He knows that you can do it. He called Noah because He knows that Noah can build a boat. He called Moses because He knew that Moses can go to Pharaoh. When God called you to be a pastor, to be a church elder, God knew. God is calling you, He knew. He knows the DNA, He knows the DNA that placed in your mother's womb for you. He knows your quality, He knows your talent. Hallelujah. That's why He called you. None of us that we are here, we come because we want to come. No. We are here in whatever churches. Church is something of God. Maybe we are not doing it right, but it's of God. Yeah. Amen. All the churches. The churches are called by God to establish, and it's the only institution that talking about the kingdom come. I don't know, right? There is no other organization. There is no other company. There is no other department that talks about the kingdom come, the God. It's coming. There's hell. There's heaven. Only the church. So we must respond. We must take it very seriously. Don't take it lightly. Amen. So the ministry is a call by God. But many Christians are slow in obeying the call of God for the advancement of the ministry. We are taking our time. We are taking time. We are not. We don't have the urgency to do it. The people are dying and going to hell. Hallelujah. We just brush it aside. We just make fun. And somebody, you know that somebody, when he dies, he'll go to hell. If somebody is drinking, if the person dies, he'll go to hell forever. Forever and ever. But we are not responding. We'll say, mind your own business. No. We mind other people's business. They'll go to hell if they die. That's why the church is called. Maybe the government, maybe the Manua, or maybe any other organization, maybe any other company, they leave it aside. But the church, that's why the church is called. Amen. Abram said in Jesus' story, Abram said, there are prophets in the world today. They are talking about this place. So the church, our message is a message. Go to heaven. Don't go to hell. I mean, you can receive blessings while you're following God. But that's not the primary reason of the church. The primary reason of the church, when you finish from here, you go and meet Jesus. That's the primary role. It's good to have a big house. It's good to have a big organization. To have a church that impacts the nation. It's good to have that. But the primary role of the church, to show the way to heaven. Amen. To talk about Jesus. Amen. Amen. But we are very slow in that. Hallelujah. My second paragraph, just go back. Second paragraph, 2-3. God has a time and He knows what is happening and what will happen. As we roll, nobody knows what 2017 will bring. Some were sitting here last year. They are no longer here. Amen. Amen. Some of us, we were enjoying last year. But now you feel that you are struggling this year. Hallelujah. Amen. Only God knows what will come around the corner. Behind Donnelly Park, only God knows what will come next. Hallelujah. We can see only up to Donnelly Park and up King's Road, the RFMF camp. But God knows what's behind that. As you go up in Kinoya, as you go down to the Sinu, only God knows that, the unseen. Amen. And we are very slow to react. Praise the Lord. As leaders, we must have an eye of eagles. Very sharp. You know the eagles, when they're flying 4,000 feet, 5,000 feet above mean sea level, they can see, they can spot a rat, mongoose, snake. Their eyes are very sharp and very clear, very, very, very powerful. Their lens. And leaders, we must have that eyes. Not physically, because we are connected to the Holy Spirit, we can have that eyes. You discern. We call it discernment. You are discerning what's coming next. Amen? Okay, few things in number one. Number one, be serious about the call. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, be serious. When you are serious about the call, environment will not affect you. The rain will not affect you. Hallelujah. Yesterday when I came to Kirsten, I arrived there at 3:35. I look around and all the markets were empty. Hallelujah. I invited to Radin and said, this place is empty. Just because of a late night on the 31st affects our service on the 1st. I continue my Bible and I told Radin, no wonder we are blessed. Because the environment and situation of the past will never stop us from the future. Some of us leaders, we are sitting here, The things that you are facing today, you're facing yes, you faced yesterday, really affect your performance tomorrow. Leaders, they don't, nothing affect them. They're quick to rise, they're quick to go. They might fall, but they're quick to stand up again. Those are leaders. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, see, you come here, you really struggle coming here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And as we came here, I asked Dr. Nesimus, the wind was like this. No, just lazy. Yeah, okay. Very soon we'll quiet down and then we'll be like this again. God only wants to show you that He's in control. Because so many Sundays, so many Mondays will be like this. When just about for us to arrive, there'll be strong wind and rain and people will just, maybe the tent about to fall down. It's okay. We can be in the rain. We can get wet. Just go and have bath again and then dry. But don't allow the situation and environment to affect you. Hallelujah. Be serious. When you are serious about the call, you want everything to be done properly. I saw the Bible yesterday or this morning. When we cannot get through to FBC, I think it was in Amukelau, 8 minutes before the cut off time, we were cut off. Maybe because of the balance in the telecom line. That's what I think. Why? Because we are not serious. When we are serious about anything, we prepare well. You don't go to the rugby field, go and make jokes. No. You're going there, somebody will tackle you, somebody will put your head onto the ground. You are not going there to play party or play cowboys, no. When you're going there, there's a mouth guard in your mouth to safeguard you. You are going there for kill. I mean, not only kill the person. You are going there because you're serious. Hallelujah. Not any small tackle, you start to cry and complain. Okay, I'm going to get a lot of people. Hey, I'm going to get a get out. Amen. No. Get some real tough game. Hallelujah. But that's men's game. Amen. Leaders are men's game. Hallelujah. But that's it. That's the rule of the game. You make mistakes, rise again, move on. Don't cry over the spilled milk. One pussycat will come and lick it for you. No? You serious? Make it serious. You are leaders. You are holding the pattern. That pattern must not fall down. It must be transferred to the next step. Because you want your team to be win. Ruah told, when God calls, He is serious and ready to use us to the call. Therefore, our availability is important. Say with me, availability. If you are serious with God, one thing that you must know, your availability is there. There should be no excuse that you are too tired or you are very busy. No, that's not an excuse of a person that is very serious with the things of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can I get a hallelujah in there? Take ownership and be serious of what you are doing, because that is the call of God in your life. It's not a position. It is a call of God in your life. God called you. Huh? The one who sent the stars into spaces, the one who tells the wave to stop here, is the one who is telling you to stand up. Hallelujah. I was sharing with the people in Santa Rosa, I think the Tal Talangase, look at this zero or the O. Look at this O. Everybody can see this O?
Yeah.
Imagine that is the planet Earth. Hallelujah. And for us Fijian, the position of the geographical position of Fiji is somewhere here. This is the equator half. Fiji is somewhere here. That means our feet is stuck to the ground. You think that we are vertical. No, we are on the side. We are on the side like this. New Zealand is upside down a little bit. That's how we look. If we go out into the space and we look at the planet Earth, your head is stuck out. Why can't you fall?
Amen.
Because all this and the gravity in this, only God knows that. It's an unseen force that allow the Kiwis, the New Zealanders, upside down already, like their legs is up like this. And they walk around, they eat, they go to sleep. They are sleeping upside down. That's when I was sharing, God is the one who tells the waves, come to this far, here. The waves here, the waves here, the waves here. God said, come to this far only. That's the same God. I'm bringing this picture to you. That's the same God that is calling you to do the work. So if he said to the waves to come up this far, he can tell to any wave that come against you, come this far.
Hallelujah.
I have my son, I have my daughter walking there.
The Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen. When you understand how it operates, then you realize the power in God's word.
Amen.
Amen. So don't take it lightly. We are blessed. The time when we finish from this life, the time when we'll come to God and they worship him day and night, then you realize, man, I could have done better. Sahawati. Amen. When we work for the government, when we work for the company, we do our best, especially if our boss is watching us. But our boss only watches us from 8 to 5. But God watches you every day. He never sleeps nor slumber. And he mentioned, that's the boss that we are reporting to. We are not working for New Methodist. We are working for God.
Amen.
The organization that we work for, that we work with, that God uses as a vessel, is New Methodist.
Amen.
Amen. So when God called, he called New Methodist. The church, the ministry. And you are the worker of the ministry. The same God who put the sun, the light into the sun. The same God that put the rain up yonder to fall on the time like this. The same God is trusting you to do the work.
Amen.
Hallelujah. To make it closer to you. When this God come closer to you, then the big problem comes away from you. Hallelujah. The reason why the problem is so big to you, because your God is so far away from you. So when this God comes to you, then you see the problem goes away from you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Slap your neighbor, tell your neighbor, see, your problem is not big. You are serving a big God.
Yeah.
Whenever you see your problem, see your God. Because there's no problem bigger than your God.
Amen.
Whenever there's a big problem coming your way, you look to God. Don't look at the problem. Look to God. Whatever, how high the problem, how wide the problem, you look to God. Because your God is greater than the problem.
Amen.
Give a hand clap to the Lord. Number two. See, A, serious about the call. B is what? Come in again.
Serious about the ministry.
Okay, go to A. Go back to A. Kalima, 2, 3.
Serious about the call.
See, the serious about the call is you. You are called. Now, B is serious about the ministry. That's the one you are called to do. So God is calling you. And now God calls you to go and work in the ministry. Jeremiah 1. Go to X 8:9-3. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. After he said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. See? Now you are called by God. Serious about the call. Now you are called to the ministry. Be serious about the ministry. Because the one that called you already departed. You will be the one seen. You will be the one out there to deliver the goods that given by God. Hallelujah. So that is the call. That is the purpose of you being called to witness about Jesus. Most of the leaders today, we don't exercise our right as a child of God or called by God to be a witness. The church is the organization that train you and make you to be a witness of Jesus. Can people see Jesus in you? See? Are you a very powerful witness of Jesus wherever you are? Amen. Sari mina ngana turang sebe be. Tarung ko to ka sa musi no de ngana chisu be ko. Kombera ko yali. Hallelujah. Amen. The only reason why Jesus need you because you will be the representative of Jesus wherever you are. If you work in the government, you are the representative of Jesus in the department of government that you work with. If you are in the private sector, you are the representative. You are the ambassador. They can't see Jesus, but they can see Jesus in you. You are supposed to represent Jesus. It's not about only coming to church and sit together and sing hallelujah chorus. No, it's about in our workplace that we represent Jesus. Hallelujah. That you are serious with your life. You walk, you talk like Jesus. Because Christ is in you. It's no longer I that live, but Christ lives in me. When he lives in you, your body demonstrates Christ in you. Hallelujah. Kembali langsung dan turun mesenga. Nambaran turun mesenga. Namun dia sama ahli. Tapi kau tukar sama sahal. Lebun dina. Haleluya. Aku sini kan ada banyak lebun dina. Kami kau sahal. Lebun dina. Tak beli kat mana? Tak beli kat mana? Beli kat mana? Kau Ruah tolu. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem. I will not be in Jerusalem anymore. I will not be in Judea anymore. I will not be in Samaria or to the end of the world. I will not be there. You will be there. I will be in you. Hallelujah. That's why wherever you go, you must be a representative of Jesus. Hallelujah. When the senior pastors were praying in San Francisco International Airport, that's the representative of Jesus. Kesini lagi kena mas ni, sih asal lagi kena mas. Kesini orang ikan hallelujah amen ni, esar orang ikan hallelujah amen. Kalau orang ini beri tunggu beri kereta hallelujah, tapi rey itu main tuan. Amen. You are the representative of Jesus. That's why the Bible says, Paul said in Romans chapter 1, verse 16, I'm not ashamed of that. Gospel, because this is the power of God. The power of God is in the gospel. What is the gospel? The message about Jesus. The gospel is the message about Jesus. That is the reason why we here. That's the gospel. The gospel is kind of a packet into a package. That's the gospel. So when you talk about Jesus Christ, that's the gospel. Amen. Are you sharing Jesus Christ wherever you go? Because that is the gospel. That he came to the to the world, die on the cross. Amen. And when he died on the cross, he rose again on the third day, and now he's sitting at the right hand side of God. Even though he's there, he's here. Because he's here, he's there. When he's there, he's there. He's sitting physically, Jesus is sitting on the right hand side of God. But because of his presence in the power of the Holy Spirit, we will be very difficult for us to understand. While he's sitting on the right hand side of God in the throne room, at the same time he's here with us. Because he's God. We cannot explain it. Because our mind is limited. Amen? Hallelujah. That's why the answer from you is not, there should be no, no. That's why you, when you go through trials and temptation, when you go through the mountain, you must go through the mountain with joy. Because you know God is with you. Hallelujah. It's not a Bible verse for us just to feel good. No, he's real, he's here. I remember when Sunday night, Randini and the team about to leave Fiji to come across there. And I received a Viber saying, drop everything. I know most of us here, we read that Viber. Drop everything. Pray for the weather in Nandi. At the moment, they try to reduce the takeoff weight. Two planes already lining up, ready to take off. But it's been about 30, half an hour, or maybe 1 hour, or 2 hours. They are waiting for the weather to improve. Hallelujah. And most of the senior pastors, and I believe it comes down to your region, you read that Bible. Amen? Amen. Anybody read that Bible? Raise your hand. Amen. Put it down. Hallelujah. Some of us, we pray. Randini was saying last night during the Kirsten, thank you very much for your prayers. But for me, when I read that fiber, I was more detailed than any other person sitting here or in New Methodist. Because that is my working area. I normally work in the tower. We're clearing an aircraft or plane to take off and to land. So you know when a Jumbo going up, or 737 going up, or Airbus 300, or Airbus 330, Airbus 380. You know exactly, you must know the takeoff restriction, though. What kind of crosswind that they can take, what kind of tailwind. Tailwind means the wind blowing from behind. So they have a limitation. Aircraft, they don't have a limitation of wind blowing in front of them, because they operate like a kite. They always go against the wind. It helps them with their lift. So I knew exactly the wind is blowing from Lomolomo or Lotoka side. I know. So in the room that I was in, I prayed, thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. You've been faithful in listening to prayers. We thank you that this is, we will be a witness again. Then I changed the prayer and I spoke to the wind. Wind, that you are blowing in Nandi area right now. I command you not to blow from the north, northeast, for you to go and blow from the south or southwest. Stop blowing from Lomolomo and Lotoka. You change direction now and blow from Nandi town, Narewa, on Denarau. Right now, I command you in the name of Jesus. Why I do that? Because I know exactly what the aircraft or the airplane needed for takeoff. Those two planes, they already loaded. But for Adini and the team, they are still checking in. That means it's very easy to cut off passengers. They are still loading. Those two planes, they can wait. They are already loaded. Fuel, cargo, passengers, all already there. So there's a 99.9 chances of reducing the weight, especially for us, because most of them, they are traveling on body passes or airline tickets. So it'll be very easy to cut them off and their cargo. Hallelujah. So it was easy to identify the problem and pray. Hallelujah. very significant and very pinpoint prayers, commanding the wind to change. If you want to blow, change your direction. If not, lie down. After 30 minutes, we saw, so for those of you that are on the Bible, after 30 minutes, the airport managers communicate to Pastor Chomesa that they felt that the cloud just opened up and the wind died down. So the two aircraft took off, and Radini and the team, nobody was offloaded. Amen. You must be witnesses. Jesus. Hallelujah. So wherever you are, signs and wonders will follow you. Why? Because you have Jesus in you. Don't back off when you face with a problem. You have the one that solves the problem in you. That's why when the wind and the waves were starting to affect their trips, they wake Jesus up and said, are you allowing us to die? So Jesus stood up and speak to the wind and speak to the waves. Hallelujah. Because we are the witnesses. How can we witness? Because of the power of God in us. You can only witness in a lowering on a kalovico. But then it's about to give tambu. He's the working power of God. Holy Spirit is the working power of God. Amen. High five, Mandamiko to Kasamukabuka. He's the working power. That's why when he's with you, people will see signs and wonders. Hallelujah. Okay, staff now. So me and Randini, we came to the counter. But kerong talaga, kerong lang ito na staff travel. No na staff travel o Randini. Nang unang sarang siya tagang nagpukina, kito tumagay na tayo tumayin, na kanyang utiwati sarang, kito sa kanyang pangataka. Kero sa lain dito niya. Hallelujah. Kero sa rungo na namo sa niyo kaya na supervisor, sa na manager in the airport, sa tulad ba? Come on, another 2 minutes to go. After that, you close up. I want to take these people on. Yang kura sokan orang itu motor sepedi cuka orang troli. Satu orang itu waktu tolong. Time's up. Beli sah sunga ya. Kita sah insurna. Kura tu kura tumbiri ani kita lihat tu sokan itu full fare. Itu sahui kita nggak bata gigi itu. Amen. Itu kata tu apa ya? Because something in us, I believe, that is making a favor. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Only check the kidney row back. Hallelujah. Girl, so my ruin and narrow back. But the tuna allocation you beg you go count. Girl, so my ruin. Oh, Bakus, so I'm only so much. Go to that counter. Go and pay your two back. Oh, Salak, go to Sarika, only. Oh, Sapersani, Sasuli Nubuka, Satoroka, Satiku, Satako, Sale, Dubito, Natal Gasma in Grandi. Kasilim, Kuni, Sulin Munika, Satuka, Tony Stark. Excuse me, can you get Sapiruka? What happened? No, give him back his card, I will pay for the extra baggage. Hallelujah. Yoro tu nomor tu sala kona chini na kolo kona mataka. E ti le tu na nono tu la kome ndoma nambongi, bol tenin tu mena taku so mesu mona ne rombe. Nani? Hallelujah. So na kati ku mori ndue taka e varo taka chuna ko. See when you are serious with the ministry, somebody will send by God to help you because you are just serious. You just say yes. You say I'm ready. Yes, I can do it. But God positioned people to help you do it because that is called. He called you and he called the ministry. So it's a double call. He's waiting for somebody to say yes. You provide the water, he provide the wine. He asked Moses, what's in your hand? My walking stick. Point it to the Red Sea. Give the walking stick. He'll make the walking. Amen. But the problem is we are not taking it very seriously. Amen. No, this is not just another church. This is a move of God. It just happened that we have to go and register because it's a requirement by the government. But if this is a move of God, we are blessing the nation, we are blessing our neighbors, we are blessing our company, we are blessing the government, we are blessing our Noah, we are blessing any people that come next to us. Pastor Tay may be listening tonight. Hallelujah. He said, a lot of people, they call me, hallelujah, because Pastor Tay is the president of Fiji Democracy Fighters. Ako sana na kinailulu na daw, o posta ka na matintu may isang nandua. The Freedom Fighters. Ito na ko, sanggil may, Tay, what's happened with you? Said, oh, you should come and taste what I've tasted. Na nung page, sa sinin doon ang page ni Freedom Fighters, sa page kita nga ni New Methodist, doon ko, lakumay. I am with the first family of the New Methodist Christian Fellowship. Hallelujah. You can feel the power, you can feel the anointing. There is something different about this. At una te, wala sa nga mo, yung sa Afri, mo lang ganibit. Ewa. O ira kada ibit, ira kada na, tu ibit, ura sa nabili ka tu na comment ni te, before. Ura sa nabili ka na comment, ano ko. Nada ba siyempre ni luto kinabiyo ka na febo ni karo. That this person already changed, this person is genuine. It's not like they know that they. 4 years with the company. He's maybe one of very, very, very few of any feature, very successful back in the United States of America. A big office, very good office, well equipped for 4 years. He said, there's no pastor, there's no church ever come across to come and just sit in his office or pray with him, forget it. And he said, and this New Methodist Christian Fellowship, their general superintendent and the wife and their family, they come and sit with me. People walk past me. People speak against me. Maybe because I'm an achiever, or maybe because I always speak straight. And you walk past and you stop and to say thank you and to shake my hand, that's something. That must be God. Witness. You will be my witness. Hallelujah. Esengan ni ruana maga wa 10 days nga na nona hita ki ko na presence ni kalu. Kaya wacu sini bongi sama sulaki. Aku sakali bi gua ni kalu kota malam bi nak kenal tampu musa tala tala demita koronan koronan. Hallelujah. Tu na amred. Amen. Witnesses. How many people around you, how many people that connect with you, they don't see anything? Hallelujah. Ugi mi kota sama sa ora tali na ready ko tiko. When you have the walking power of Jesus Christ in you, hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Kung gusto mo mandang abuan na tulad. I love the way he, like a zeal and a compassion. E chico mi kwa. Hallelujah. Na si karon rebati ko gitu no pasta hit. Inga si o check ta kana na page. Sa new method is kana. Gay libo na comment si bitu ka ko. Tama ta na shock. Positive ni kan. Oh. Hallelujah. Amen. Kami ko to sa mo iko mo amala tatu e dua tapo ni mere. My, pili ko my, rotolu. Take ownership and be serious of what you are doing to the ministry and the effectiveness of the church to the general public. Hallelujah. Is NCF affecting the general public? Are they seeing something that they want to follow because they see it's very powerful? Hallelujah. Make sure that you are the vessel that God can use to bless his people and become a source of blessing to the children and the servants of God. I believe God called this church to be a blessing to the people of Fiji, serving them with the word of God. Amen. Sari minang naturan, sabi. Ningaw na ko effective kina, siya ko bakila na yalong tambo sa aliyo, takatiko na namumula, things start to change. There'll be a changing people around you because they know, they witness sa abuwa na mula kung mula chiko kina. Hallelujah. Palitan naman. Because you become a witness of Jesus Christ wherever you are. Palitan naman. You are called to the ministry. 500 people were listening to what Jesus said. Na ulibon waya liman ang raw na tamatara para mutiko. Ito na raw sa mula. Ibig ka? Okay. 120 over 500. Ebida, ebida na fraction na. 120 over 500. Cancel taka na zero. Kembali 12 over 50. Ebida na fraction na. Kiko simplify taka. Ebida? We are one quarter. One quarter? So only one quarter of people in the mountain, they are serious about the call. Three quarter they went to the city and buy the here, buy there and walk around. And two another quarter, 25%. One quarter is 25%. Are you serious about the call of God in the church? Rather, okay, bangun. Lima na raw ero tuiga, kau cisu. Ero rega na taga taga mana, ero kanya na panrai na multiply, and they eat the fish from Tiberia. And when Jesus said, when I go, I will send someone. Before that someone comes, the Holy Spirit, go and wait. Only one quarter of those that are with Jesus in the mountain, only one quarter go and wait. Three quarter disappear into the crowd. Why? They were not serious about the call. They were not serious about the ministry. Tingaw na rin ay wawa kinika, nangay lutumay na mana ni ministry. Amen. Sometimes people, they don't wait for the call in the ministry. They know that they've been called to be a pastor. They know they've been called to be a man of God. They know that. But they are not waiting for the call in the ministry. They know they have the calling, but they don't wait for the calling to the ministry. They don't want to be part of the ministry. Amen. That's why three quarter of the 500 disappear. Only 120 went and wait and wait and wait. For 50 days and 50 nights, bang, Holy Spirit comes. Acts chapter 2. And they're filled with power and they speak strange tongues. And the fire of God settle on each one of them. None of them does not have the tongues of fire. None of them. Every one of them. See, you can be called personally, but you need the call corporately in the ministry. So you can receive that flame. The flame comes because of the ministry, not because of you. Amen. Hallelujah. The flame is for the ministry. You go on fire, you go cover more than because of the ministry. That's why when you walk away from the ministry, hallelujah. And sometimes people, when they're in the ministry, on fire, when they step out, they'll be the same as they were in. No, the moment you step out, because the fire and the flame is for the ministry, not for you. So when you come back in, you receive that flame again. They were in and they went out. Hallelujah. When they went out, the flame out too. They struggle. Hallelujah. Because the flame did not come from the mountain. The flame comes when they were waiting. Waiting for the call, the corporate call, the listening. There's a leader. Amen. Yan ang muna, so ito pa nga takana ng personal call. Meron na nung sa ito yung ministry. Yan ang ministry, kung tanga may ako na ang rakay. Dito tao kinatayan na. Kadaulah ko kina. Matay ni Kris. Spirit daulah ko ikan. Spirit. Matay na spirit ni Tommy mati kina mati. Kini ko na spirit of adultery. Dia bukan daulah ko itu bapaya. Kaya saya nga nyimbala. Saya mulmulumu. Na kini ko nga na do tawira na do kabur na matumali. Hallelujah. High five me kato kaya sama kato kaya. Cikgu mohon dua. Cikgu na play. Kaya ko kena kata cikgu na kata-kata me. Come on, Chico. Chico, Amen. You can be nice inside, look good inside, but because you are inside, remember, the flame comes when they were inside, not in the mountain when they're 500. It's when you go as a corporate, listen to Peter, John, and James. Amen. Make sure that you are a vessel that God can use to bless His people and become a source of blessing to the. See, whenever the flame comes to us, it's to serve the people. It's nothing to do with us or to become famous. Amen. Because we are filled with self-centered or selfishness, that's why it's very easy when you have the flame, but you look for your own gain. Amen. Sabo daw may masulaki, sabo teacher, sabo daw munaw, sabo daw lang ang sere. Hallelujah. It's very easy for look for crowd. You want to be somebody, you want to be a main boy. That's why you walk away from the corporate, because you are not seen. You want to be seen, you want to be somebody. Nung ulang nasarang ito ba? Sini lang tapat tingin ko ng buka. Hallelujah. So you go through experience because of what you know, but what makes you perform. Hallelujah. Kaya itong pala musara, hindi manembak. Kaya pala musara. Kaya pala musara, hindi manembak. Kaya lang ko na ono bitya sa ating mumbo ko man. Amen. Kami ko ito kasama, experience nga sa ako, chika tatungo. Hallelujah. High five mo, tabi ba? Kalinja. When you are running over experience, because the environment, see, when you rely on your experience is for a certain environment. And as we move forward, the environment changes. You got no experience there. You've not been through tomorrow. So you can't depend on the experience today to face tomorrow. You need the one that's been through tomorrow. The experience of the Holy Spirit tomorrow. He's been out throughout tomorrow. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. Kawat Jesus doawa, doawa. Sintu no kami bida na madawa. Sintu no kami bida na mula. Sintu no kami bida siya tuwa doawa. He's testing their patience. He's testing how they can obey and listen for instruction. Amen. Kuni mga kusa kusa. Kuni doon mga tatolong deong gayin pera. Ay, magayin tawag ko na comments ha. Don't rush, you might get late. Eh? Hallelujah. Don't rush. Take your time. The Holy Spirit is molding you when you're taking your time. Amen? May, tasara. Pili ka may, yung itala, third point yung gori. Ruwa tolu. Carry the vision of God in the ministry. Whenever you are in the ministry, you must carry the vision. The vision. Say with me, vision. Say with me, vision. That's something that binds us together. That's what makes us go together as corporate. That's why we say the mission whenever we do our church service. We say the mission. The vision and the mission and the core values. These are the things that bind us together. The vision, the purpose. Na inakini no natiko. Na inakini NCF. Na inakini souls to Jesus. The vision. Winning souls to Jesus at any cost. Can you go ruwa? Ruwa tolu. Work the mission to accomplish the vision. See, the vision is something like building the castle in the air. It's something up there. Hallelujah. Vision. The vision na tatangra na bunilangi. The mission na ikaw tamay na bunilangi amin damera. O nakatal eh? Malaswa pa kasi virtu ngayon lagi. Untung sige lang sali virtu ngayon lagi. The vision na tatangra. Eh? Something that you dream, it's a dream. But for that vision to become a physical, we need mission. The mission will bring the vision to become something that you know and see, touch. Hallelujah. The winning souls to Jesus at any cost, and a vision. Tatara, bunilani. The mission, say, I'm going to love it with Jesus. The coming back. Hallelujah. Love it with Jesus. My, what's going to love it with Jesus? What I love? In mezzo alla signa los, che li carrua? Che li catolu? Che li capa? When you do those four things, you are doing one mission. La mission namo, me lo metti con Gesù, la metti con Adama, vivo con l'ottutaki, while waiting for your dinner, solo in the text. È una mission. La mission me la metti con Gesù, la metti con Adama con Gesù. Tu li vola di Gesù, dai. Amen. Tava mandando una tavata, tu la metti con Gesù. This is how you live Jesus. This is how you exalt Jesus. Evangelizing, knock on doors. Amen. Training like this, equipping the church, ministering to the society. Hallelujah. That's how you exalt Jesus Christ. That's how you do the mission. Make a zero mind of mission, winning souls. Era sangue logo mai na tomata vi Gesù, quando ni cola metti Gesù tipo. La metti qua guardava. Cioè. E neni sali mira na tura, eh? Hai fai qui cosa mai sam. Cavi qua samo le nuove. Ma to sarà che ni catolu understanding the time. As a leader, hallelujah. We are slow to the ministry by not understanding the time. Hallelujah. Cosa ti ho detto in January 2017? You must know that this is the first year of the last 7 years. Understand the time. This is the last 7 years. Che tu ne vacchi l'anni tu e tu ti dico che na patungo e na buro buro di vivo all'utta che tu ne facci un po' 7 years. I asked the Lord for 3 7 years. Buone oggi oggi mi dì, last 7 years. Ne ha domani 2024 che se per via su mai naturale. Quello che ha un impatto di valuta qui e non mi li vittu che non è impatto. Non mi li vittu che non è impatto. Ora che ne sono su quello che era YouTube che tu mo, non mi li vittu che non è impatto, non è powerful e non è valuta qui. Non ci casa, saluti su mai. Amen. Sangue mi lavo tu una caga molto che in-house. Eh? Anche lavo tu una song, una cell group, una release, fuori una in-house. La mia valuta che si assegna. Vivo una rete, non ho un po', io me lo dici, mi valuta di vivo, l'acqua tu mi valuta. Why? Because we ask the Lord. We ask the Lord. Amen. E a Naguna, this is our last 7 years, that the Lord said, I'll give you threefold. Threefold 7 years. Amen. Qua credi che non tu conni vada la carta che ne caro lì 7 years, nel tu che mi stacca. Hallelujah. Cosa mantenia macchi? Che mani tanto ragazzi? Tu sai che te lo vuoi lì? Tu sai che te lo vuoi lì? Because we are in the last 7 years of being forefront in evangelism world. La canatuna da capa in evangelism world. Vesico, television, radio will be always different because we request that to God. E mani? Na lì le vuoi lì da capa, lì le vuoi lì da capa, pure muria. It's a call, but understand the time, because that call has time limitation. Amen. Teachers we can train, apostle we can train, hallelujah, prophet we can train, apostle we can train, but for evangelism it's anointing, it's a gift. Non do uno voli, voli nei soli soli, do uno voli. Amen. Che male, buono uno voli, 7 years ago, vive cani, 7 years, daga daga tagico, alleluia. Tale quanto che siamo, vitu ne ambagini daga daga, vitu ne ambagini daga daga, vitu ne ambagini daga daga, kamai, vitu ne ambagini daga daga, vitu ne ambagini daga daga. Rende l'anno 2016, rende l'anno 2015, le una erba neke, le una mode. Devo una cocotto. Amen. E sono mai perché ti vivo da solo e perché non hai perché ti vivo da solo succede. A oggi ne chiedono uno mo. Tanto la casa you can have 10, you can 10, you can have 10 worship centers. Che male con Cibona Lima, per la cattività di Lima. Che con Cibona Vitu, per la cattività di Tolu. Che con Sanzini, per la cattività di Cinia. Meme, prova da, io con due worship centers erano in rise to 50. Che bello la maximum duration 500. Erano mutacchi e dei lacchi. Hey, Mandy, are you excited about the 7 years? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody got to mess up on this. Hallelujah. First training in 2017, hungry like a wild tiger, looking someone to take it home to your children. We set our target high because the God that we serve is sitting on high. No, there's no limit. Amen. My eternal time on a garden of Chigorua, God's time. God's time, yeah. I've given you another 7 years. Winning souls to the kingdom. Oh, see, do not even go to the sinners and be Malutaki. Oh, do not even illuminate Malutaki that adds other churches. Blundurikina, to Kukina Misa, and undo a tali. Because whatever we do for God comes with anointing. Hallelujah. The Bible is saying, 2025, 2026, to the people who are not focused on 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 7 years to be a long time. No, 7 years is just like 1 year. They keep the language as if they do. So, tell the language. Because of laziness, laziness brings a lot of sleepy head, sleepy eyes. Okay, I'm going to sit with you. 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 So God's time, your time, you have your time. Be careful, your time is it's mostly waste time, your time. Be careful of your time. Manage your time properly. When you pass through, it'll never come again. One of those is time. When you pass 2016, it will never come again. How is it? Amen. Amen. To the people of the Japanese, how is it 2017 and second time? So make sure when you come down from January to December 2017, you must make use of every moment. To the Chorandini Nanoa, Donambakis, how also did 2016. Hallelujah. 2017, who knows, might be even busier than 2016. Amen. Kebagasa sengani busy on a national level, I believe God allow that the busyness will come down to the zone. Kebale tantalagase, take you from there. Hallelujah. Binagatake ke cancel taki nobu program because of a national program. Misa tubotunga na nobu program. If you want to win souls to Jesus, amen. Mission reward me bagalebu. The soul matanga meti ko na kena mission reworkers. So na marama, hallelujah. Esanga ni mission ringa orto na garbo so na mission team. Esanga the mission is anyone that is available to take the gospel. locally or internationally. So we need some woman to be a mission in zone. Amen. Mungkin kau tu bersama. Taruh ni gua. Nalap aku siang di mission lagi. Taruh gua. Taruh gua. Why can't you become a missionary? See, everybody can become a missionary, but not everybody can become a pastor. Everybody can become a missionary, not everybody can become an apostle or prophet. You are a missionary in your own right. Amen? So your time, make sure your time. Come to care of my time. Come to care of my time. I will use my time. I will use my time. I will use my time. There will be no waste time. Because it's my time. I will not waste my time. Olá, no nome prero. Olá, tu grande chegou. Tal tal gase. Olá. É? O tu grande tal tal gase na nova. Olá. Digo, mission lead tipo de qua. Tal tal tipo de qua. Full time. Tchê tchê de qua. Tu se tipo que não lutou. Não usado as gritas. Vanga lá, tá com a moniti que não vai rombuca. Moniti, rest. Do some work in the house. Friday, family time. For those 3 days, you can reduce to 2 days. Yeah? Tuesday and Thursday. But if you are worker, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Program takkan tuan program. Pergi mana benda? Orang tiga mana walu, bima mana walu. So even you ketemu mana dua. Menunggu time sana. The reason why the workers are working, because they have a program. 8 o'clock, they must be in the office. 10 o'clock, tama. Tea break. 1 to 2, lunch break. 3 o'clock, tea break. 5 o'clock, go home. So their body is used to the timetable. That's why they're working. They have a timetable. Get a tone of my time. A rendezvous can be waste time. But they sit on a program and push the ego. Men need program. We need program to drive us. Kaya malapit at yun na kaloko, paspaso, yung kaya chin. Chin na kaloko, yun na tea, break. 10:30, yun na mupuli mo ang tapo. There are notes like this that are available in the office. So you have a 1 hour, 1 hour 45 minutes, 1 hour 15 minutes. O yung kumata nga, Bible study to matagin ko. Go through the lesson. Amen. And then take you to lunch time. Kasi nga na lolo, o kasi nga lebo may nandua, kinarua. Hallelujah. Ruan na kaloko, doon mo program ni Mexico. Se doon na mo, kadi mo tala mayroon sa pre-wares, mas tala. Amen. Doon mas may naruwa kinatolo, sa ruwa kinamantolo. Amen. Doon tala 30 minutes break. O siya, kayo doon na kina Mexico. Se doon tala kina Bible study. O siya kino na mo siya. So when you program your life, your body will respond to the program. You know you have to do something. When you don't have any program, you become idle because nothing is driving you. So if you are not careful, get on a full time, then we are not doing anything. Full time. Amen. Woman, then you are sitting here, you want to be a missionary in your zone. Let tolu se leva. Le wono toko minakasara. Kegele chini toka marama. The maximum is 12. Do the mission. Missionaries of the zone. These are the people they visit. These are the people. Don't wait for evangelism. The best method of winning souls ever is visitation. They can be voluntary. Visitation is number one. Because we leave our comfort zone and we come to the subject or to the people that we want. They are cut down because you are concerned about their life. Tapi malu tak kita cuma main di sana, orang cuma di sana. They have every option not to come to the altar. But when you come to their home, you can only be kirai. Karena kaya powerful kina orang tuan Jehovah's Witness. I always take my hat off, Jehovah's Witness. Kita bos tak kira, saya pernah di lalu tuan Kristo. But the method they use is very powerful, very effective. And what is that method? Visitation. Amen. So New Methodist Christian Fellowship, we look around. That's what leaders are supposed to do. You look around. When you see the method that is better than any method, we utilize. Don't we sit on our maybe self-righteous attitude, maybe arrogant attitude. We don't want to learn from other people. No. You know the businessmen? When they see a businessman successful, they come there, they copy what you're doing that is different. We want to copy your method. Yan ang loti chisun into a success. Dagay tama, dagay kaset, at dusia pagalawa. That's why we are struggling. We look around. Demeni. Aw na ngon na urin na kina may nanti. Ngano to yapa na tuwar to na Jehovah's Witness. Matikin to na momani. Aw sa tuwara. Mission. Ngay muli na mabiba lutaki. Ngayon matanga na misiko. You'll see mission. They will be on the road. With their sulu, with their necktie, they will be on the road. Every day. Every day. Amen. Because visitation is the most powerful tool to win souls to Jesus. Kaya kayo siya kung manabila na marama, pero ito yung hindi na. Oh, may mo na marama, tungo rival, at kanito naman yung matara. They are looking, what is the answer? What is the solution to their problem? You know the solution. You've been in the church. You can do it. You don't have to be a preacher. You don't have to know the Bible verses. You just testify what the Lord has done in your life. Amen. High five, madami ko ito kaysa. Kami ko sa akin ang unang mo, may narulaway ang and the last one is very slow. My, hindi ko matawag yung rotolo. Very slow in reacting to the need of the church, taking your time in the things of God and His church, saying to yourself, hindi na nagkatsa ka, oh no, ewan na nakanda daw kahit to kenda na daw, hindi ni luto. May, pililiw na sa na yung matawag yung rotolo. That it can be done tomorrow, number one. Two, it can be done later, number three. We have a lot of time, so take your time. We have a lot of time. Number four, I have a lot of time to do it. Number five, I'm busy now, I will do it later. Number six, I have a lot more important things to do than that. Hallelujah. Those are our time. Your time, my time. We always have excuses. And we take the things of God very lightly. Okay, lang na visit mo tayo. Siya ngayon doon, tangin siya ni buwan. Amen. O, tuwara ka na tibili mo malo tayo. Siya ngayon doon, tangin siya ni buwan. Hallelujah. Ma, ito, Sarah. Kaya ka, ba? True at all. Be careful of deception. Hallelujah. We are slow to the ministry because there are some barriers. It's not a deception. It's not a kanimi magavavai. That's why we are slow to the ministry. Amen? It's not a kai magalatilatitiko na nondarumbula. We are sitting here, all of us. We are not really quick to do what God wants us to do because there are other deceptions. Dosangamo au. Kamatiki au. O aw do mina kata menggara mitu gai gai. Do na lang galing mo aw. When aw becomes number one, asa pera kita ngan ka. Amen. We struggle with the church growth because aw is in front. Comfort bango. Kaya tao tao na uda di kuat. Tugay sa kamay ni mataka. Mataka sa pati tao na uda. Tugay sa kamay ni mataka mo. Because Ao doesn't want to get wet. Ao does not want to go to the sun. Amen. So one big problem of church growth is self. Amen. My to sala Revelation. Will you remember Revelation? Revelation chapter 10, verse 6. Through and told. And he swore by him who lives forever and ever, who created the heavens and all that is in them, the earth and all that is in it, and the sea and all that is in it, and said, there will be no more delay. Revelation, we got no more delay. No more delay. Hallelujah. Now, when we talk about the things of God, all these things, na vale, motuka, tanaraka, nabi watini, nabi tinani, nabi tamani. Tapi kini waktu tamu tu kena talak sesi kau nanoa. Kau lama nak bagai pun awatini, kau lalu kau sini yang dia. Might as well go and enjoy your marriage. You don't come here. Tunggu cuma talak sesi kau nanoa. Those who love their children more than me, siniang dia, siniang kamu dia. Kembali dua teman sacrifice level tiba ke kau nak kata. Lubiko, sini karora. Amen. Sini kami mai rotu lagi nana pulau bawa male-male. No, it's about kaku ba. Take up your cross and follow me. Amen. Kau kopi tempat kita ini. Turang kita tu sampai tu we leave this, we leave that. We leave our everything and come and follow you. Amen. Any reward for me? Kita tu kita nak tahu macam tu vale. Kula any larger. They could have gone to university, or they from there proceed on to hold good jobs. Amen. O bina kata tiba tu nang una if we gone 20 years time from now, they will never regret choosing to work in the ministry. That's what we have time to do. That they will never regret. That they will thank the Lord that they listen to us by taking up the gospel. Amen. That they will not sit and say, oh, mom and dad make mistakes. We could have gone and studied and become an accountant, become a lawyer. Aw sini mereka tu minta orang orang beron lagi kaki nak. That our parents make mistakes. Hallelujah. Whenever we come from overseas, whenever, whatever they want, we want to meet them. Beron lagi kaki tu nak. Beron kita kaki orang balik tak kaki. Kerun ni mulia ni orang balik. Kerun ni mulia ni orang mereka. We want them. We want to show them that working in the ministry can look after their home, look after their family. Hello, Chisweka. Chisweka. That is the statement from Jesus. Eka buba. Okoy sabi na tamana, sena tinana. Sabi tira na wekan. Alam mo yung muriyal. And I andraw na bulan mo. Andraw na bulan mo. Amen. Because we are slow to the ministry. Kerun do rida. Elebu na misan. Elebu na misan. They rise to a level. Memang nusara ngam mereka bagai lesi-lesi kini merlaku, and they decide to go and work. Hallelujah. Kisah nama nak kerana dua bintang nota kan? Orang orang sini ada tu cuma nanti dorong mula kita lama. We were working, and because we are very serious with the ministry, number one we left our work, number two we excel in what we are doing. Why? Because the same energy, in the same time, in the same effort, in the circular world, we use it in the ministry. We don't come to the ministry and half our effort or half our knowledge and our wisdom and just come to the ministry. No. As they sit in the office, they have a board meeting. They have management meeting, they have management training. Exactly what they do in the secular world, we are doing it in the ministry. Now training every Monday on a management training in the Buddha and the secular world. This is a management training. Kiko sabera ni kila, kila ni kwa. Kiko sena ni mdawa tenta kana management training, kina ino magalaka. Some of you are not qualified to attend management training. You go management training to be there. Tunialo, Mrs. Sakiti, Rati Tatalanga, my new town. My Santa Rosa, get to know her. Nanongu the cover, nanongu doctor. Sabi, who is a Gavi on the management training and I get to be there. Yana level on Indua, Natamatamoto to Namuku. Kerana orang nak doktor, saya sibuk dengan masters, saya lebih doktor. Ada ucap cini korin ni buku. Dapat cikin orang di tempat lagi asam ini utam. Jadi kamu kau yang nak tukun yang lutiko. Nak training ike, kamu ke apa kali pun nak open doors, opportunity, namun yang lagu gini. So terang apa tu di tempat lagi asam cikgu orang baru macam ini. Erlina kamu nak management training. Elebuna Carolina Cabra went through those universities, tertiary organization. They went through. Nakamel, toto kina yatulau again, to sama tiko meratsko. Kuni toro mga mama na training na kasi ko. Because that is the reason. Number one lesson ni kwa. Slow to the ministry. Kaya kwa ata kapat siya mo degree kung sini mister kwa ano mo. Kaya kwa ata kapat siya mendo na ano mo masters kwa mendo na partner training kung sini mister kwa mo. And the second bagan ni Solibi kwa ito na isala. Second bagan ni Solibi kwa ito na hand clap ni kwa sila sa may and a platform may na whatever, waterfall. But God is looking and watching you when you attend every Monday training. We call it the management training. Who give you the example? We got management training for managers. Who give you the example? That means you are manager. You are manager in whatever areas. For whatever we naka ilabo, whatever we naka nanumu wingarabi, whatever we naka kakana, whatever we naka nanumu time. You are managers in the old land. And romo romo le mutunga, you go to the visina. Amen. The second in the university, you manage your time, you manage the little money that you have, you manage your house. You manage the space in your house. Or That's managing. You are trying to manage you to turn right. Amen. So when we manage you and train you to go and manage down in your worship center, in your zone, the level of training. Amen. You're going to build a bit of training. Training when you go to zone. And some of you are well qualified to pass on the information. You are well qualified. You are. Some of us are even over qualified. Amen. When you are well qualified. Hallelujah. My TV weekend and the moment is going. Deception is the work of the devil, that he wants to deceive us of the truth and sell his lies to us. It is our duty to be what? To be on watch and be sober, to discern all the scheming ways of the devil. Eh? Kebal na tebo rong kebal sangat yu mo yuko lep tu ngano mo waste time. Mo kapo di bangat ako bilang ano mo time. Yuko si bangat ako bilang ano mo time. Mo ngano mo yuko kapo kapo chumi ko na tebo. Amen. No mo time kere, time kere, time kere. Time kere. No mo time kere. Hallelujah. And these are the things that come between your time and the call of God in your life. Wili kapo yung matikyao. Ruotol. Work and jobs can be deceiving. Oh, awaso-aso. Hallelujah. Oli nga, awaso-aso. Amen. Amen. Ikoro ni waso-aso na wikake de taleso. Kuangan ni waso-aso na kanikalu. Kanikalua, rua tolu. Games and hobbies can deceive our commitment to the ministry. Nang gito. Eh? Kinakamu talitaka. Hallelujah. Nang gito kinakamu talitaka. Sports, games, hobbies. Money and wealth can deceive us from our ministry involvement. O au na liwang nataka nung ilako. Hallelujah. Ibu mo maro chika nung ilako na kata. Pero alubi mo? Pero magmo mo? Na invest lemu nondua o invest na kanikalim. Waktu kau kau gue enam bulan tu ngah, lagu mereka tu kanda kalau lagu, lagu mereka rata mandar lagu, kita lagu mereka kena dalam lagu, aku yang gue itu. Nih gue sandi nabi kau yang gue lewat ke itu na, aku yang alif aku yang omega. Musa bertanya pakai doa umum mau, pakai doa umum untuk pakai nanti kena, nanti dia mau nak kaji kalau. Kira orang itu kau, kau we see that. Nih pakai uniform na zone siapa, mas tu ngah, tadi dia utol. Misal sate itu tidak mau. Hallelujah. Mal kelam. Mal dah uniform kondara ko turun lagi. Misal sate, ibu nak tukik kita mesti dikalui, mesti dikalui nak kena impact. Some people, some marriages, they are restored by the message that they receive. Lagu na YouTube tu kita. Lagu kita Facebook itu kita. Olah aku kena matamubale.com itu kena. Pada apa? Mission Sunday kena sulit itu. And we think that very likely. Ni ko soli bale temen tu rakana mata. Oh, tartara undul nga. Kena kana ya mo. Kau talelui, kena talemua.
Misan sa ate, doon ang rusa kabulo. Doon ang tulis ang kabulo. O kaya daw mo muta, kung ito sila na ka, e na punuwa, kita simpre, dali mga tagi mga tama. Kaya pala, ikaw sinisulia sa ramon, dito kaya lingap, ikaw sila nga, kaya minutal mo utang. O to ramay na numutang ngayon sa nungo, kung bintang utang ngayon sa nungo. O kaya pangang nga, mga linay. Money and wealth can deceive us from our ministry involvement. Siya nga nito na kaya mo mo, kung kutagin yung bulubulo. Dali. Nothing in this world you take into the cemetery. Everything comes out. O na nga dapat kakinan mo yun din, ako sa mga. O siya matangan ikot sa mga nagay. It just evaporates into the niya. Muku na kilakanan o mukuroy. O na nga dapat kakinan mo yun din, yan wado. Na brain, na gray matter, tuwi kaya wado. Dissolve wado. Noon rin muli tayo ito na ulo. Katoro. Kaya pala na nung umula, raw-raw ito ka na kinakulim. Raw-raw ito ka. While you're still alive, while you still have the opportunity to serve God, don't slow to the ministry. The ministry need people. And that people is you. Amen. Hindi dalawa ko kanyang mulimulo sa sertali. Sa sertali doon na kaya naka. Sertali doon na kaya. And sa wara ka ito ka na singalim mo karirin mo. Kundi yan na yan today. Amen. Kini ka ba akin, kini matuti. Ruwa tol. Relationship and wrong crowd ruins a good character. Garon ang nanda mula, may maliway. Garon ang nanda mula, nanda mula nanda duiti ko kita. Relationship and wrong crowd. Ako ni kutsi ko na mula nanda remove your integrity. Don't be with the people that they remove, they suck on, they continue to suck on into your good character. Be with the people that you rub off. You go rub any, rub mine. Be with the people that they have something to nurture your character, your integrity. Over about any kuha. We are slow to the ministry. Mo ito na, ilim mo na kaya, mga tatawa, ilim mo na kaya, mga latilati. Tentu na minsan, tatan niya, kung nabito yan mo. Over about 2017, may tunay maki ni Hanan Ramaki. Makena limbo. Irreversible. God's irreversible miracles. Satu bawah itu na miracles. God already planned and planned. It's already there. Let's do it. Let's go out there and do it. Dalam usung pun ada kawan-kawan, dan isu main angga-angga. Menurut nak kirim nalang lagi. It can be done. We are all equipped by God. Sengan itu yang tambah cikgu dikua. Iko na nikah. Ni sengan ni keluar. Sengan ni mute itu na kami. We are all sitting here. Nurtured and called by God to be serious. And we have part to play. No worship center, and a zone of Tikokina, and a ministry of a woman, a man, a youth of Tikokina, a woman, every one of us are called. Let us rise to that call. 2017, the first of the 7 years. Let's start right. Let's start with a bang. Amen. Let's win a lot of souls to the kingdom of God. How we do that? Exalt Jesus Christ. We give Him the glory, the honor, and the praises to be His and His alone. Pagkasusok mo na nga buwan at ilang. Kayo na. Ilang natin ko na tal-tal ni Sir Rico. Autor siya ko nang unang mo, minababi niyo minakatang-matang nga ng kalawag. Langat siya ko na matangi. Langat siya ko na matangi. Doktor mo na nga nang unang mo, minababi niyo minakatang nga ng kalawag. And a kaya rakaba. We all saw 2016. We all saw it. Sangat di dua weekend itu di kue, sangat di rain dan kata kamu nak kamu 2016. Hallelujah. Tambah kami juga katakan curangan. Kasar nak kamu. Sona kai pepe, sona kai moses, sona kai tabutu, sona kai tao. Ya Bapak, bila bina katakan na kalau, na bawa bini singa dengan. Sama ngaru sirabi ani na puta ni wengkelam. Au challenge tangan itu na pula di buah. Hallelujah. We have a reality in front of us. The irreversible miracles of God prepared. Kami ko di ko na nung ikoma. Let us worship Him. Kikubiyan tuli matigyan, tuli matigyan. Hallelujah.
Together, as we commit the first quarter of 2017. Let us sing together. Come on, your Lord, we know. Praise your mighty name.
Lord, you are so faithful to me.
You are so faithful.
I give you all the glory and the honor. Lord, you are so faithful to me.
Turano sama sula kana non rembula. Kurina linda sera tsukini kuwa kira no sara sara maga rongmai. Sama sula katurangan yang matai ni tol lemula the first quarter of this year, we commit unto your hand. Some of us, we are going through financial situation. Some of us, we are going through marriage problem, a family problem. Some of us, we are going through other social activities that are not right, that are not good. And we thank you, Father, as we commit it tonight. We thank you that your victorious hand will lead us and guide us. We thank you, Father, that we'll take it by the horn because of your power, because of your glory, because of your revelation knowledge, that we'll walk through because of you, O Lord. You will be glorified, Lord, that we'll see the signs and wonders moving our midst, O Lord. Na bulog ng January, na bulog ng February, na bulog ng March, na nukalo. Kaya mamila saramakin na nalinga mo nina ni mamiklo. Kemudian tosa, kemudian apa bala na? Lama ni yang bagi buat 2017. Kemudian serapa bagai ini dan yang kita tol ni, kita tol lah mula satu mata kita. Ni yang ber, ni yang tosa tak kita le, tosa tak kita le, tosa tak kita le. Lama ni bi pagarut taki dan yang mami kau. Kemudian bi setabi, kemudian bi pagarut taki, kemudian bi pagar tabu lidi, kemudian bi tuli lagi dan yang mami kau. Kemudian sedia nak kau kau nak mula. Kemudian sedia nak kena bagai lama taki, nak bi kau kena kita tanda taki, mata mata orang taki. Kemudian pagarut taki. Thank you, Father, because when you call, you keep the call. You qualify the call by your call. And we thank you for tonight. Turana, give me some receive taka. No money me so tabi in any mandibula. We receive it tonight. We are receiving it right now. We are receiving it right now. Think of a minute. Think of a minute. Bula mga mata mo bali. Bula mga ilabo. Bula mga yango. Vigom, vigom ito. Wasa mi nagataka na tura. Wasa mi nagataka. Katolo tali ni mula na. Tosa na kitali. The third quarter will be another level. And the last quarter will take us to another heights. Wasa mi nagataka na tura. Wasa mi nagataka na. Thank you, Lord. We praise your mighty name. We receive it tonight. We receive it tonight. We receive it tonight. Irreversible miracles. Irreversible blessings that you will provide to our life, to our families, and to the ministry. And we will be careful to give you the glory, the honor, and the praises to be yours and yours alone. In Jesus' name we pray, and all the children of God shout. All the leaders of God shout. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Lulu mendengar ini kata sama mau ia sama matau. Hallelujah. Korang tu mikir dalam seri. Amen. Ila kata dalam seri apa kau bila kata kita lihat na ilokolokolokol ini Santa Rosa. Okelah sama kau bila kata kita kembali. Dan sama kau ini tu 2017 kau ada sana. Nana mak itu kau ini. Kita lagu kita Holy Land. Amen. Kamu tak itu kau kata sama Holy Land tua is for me. Kami kau kami kau, mana isu apa ni? Bos itu mahu gay set tu mai. Kau di set mai biau, kau di set ni rendi ni. Bos aku kami kau, Holy Land tua is for me. Ruwet tu.
Holy Land tua is for me.
Maraming ganda na itatanisere o sulatan na Valentin Isoli sa nagkato ni Isoli may kaw na gamay na makamiling na nakakalangan na turana makamiling na nakakalangan na turana.
Holy Spirit, we thank you in Jesus' name. Jesus is Lord. Lord be the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Darangan yung desukatigo, tigo rin sa na